Today I will cover something is important, how to integration machine learning with seismic inversion. So this is important to a lot of people. So a lot of people need to import and need to admit, sorry about it, still many people need to join again. I want to start, so I will screen now. Okay. So, machine learning is a technique to integrate. If anyone have problem for video or audio or anything, you can contact me directly. I am Mohammed Shahata, Senior Geophysicist, International Trainer. It is our pleasure to sharing in many courses from different people around the world, from Yemen, from Libya, Pakistan, Indonesia, and I had got many recommendations from different people, and I will be more than happy to sharing knowledge with different people from Colombia and other countries. Agenda today, we will cover the introduction about the machine learning and the machine learning workflow and how to integration the data analysis. So the rules today and what is the difference from this webinar and the other different, we will focus about the data analysis. So this technique is very, very important. We still, we have some people want to attend it. I don't know. This is also need me some admit. Sorry about it again. Usually a lot of people delaying. I don't know why. That's okay. Sorry about this, because a lot of people asked me and blame me about the, some delaying, so I must waiting them. So today I will focus about the integration of data analysis of machine learning. So this is a key point. It is not black box. So this is the key. And also I will have some case study from New Zealand in our data. So the first, what is the difference between human and machine? So there is large difference between both. If we think about Sherlock Holmes, and he tried to search and solve some crime problem, so he collected many evidence and collected many keys to solve the crime problem. So Sherlock Holmes worked like analyst. So he analyzes data to predict the solution for the crime. So this is the same situation for machine learning. We have some robot or software, and we want software to create some auto tracking of horizon. So we try to training software how to analyze data to correct the auto peaking and get the best peaking of horizon or fault or anything else. So this is the same workflow. The problem for training software, usually it is not like human, because we as a software not have imagination, so he analyzes data. So we need to training software analysis more than data, and have the workflow, best workflow, to help the software to create the best model for each case. So this is a key point. So the human think and imagine and collect data and analysis, and also software collect data and analysis, but not have image, not have vision for in mind. So this is a problem for the software. We need to training software a lot of time, like practicing many times to get the best result for prediction. Why is the machine learning is important for geology or geophysics or geoscience? Because we need usually we have a lot of a huge amount of data, and the analysis of this data is difficult for human. So we need some softwares help us to predict the data and help us to reduce time of analysis of data and predict the fishes or soils. We have three case study, or maybe three major important goals. First one is cluster, second one is classification, third one is regression. Cluster is depend on unsupervised. So that means we let software automatically predict the mesology without any help. So he gave me some colors, and this color maybe indication the mesology we have. Another important is classification. The classification is another important point. So what is a classification? The difference between classification is depend on the supervise. So that means we help software. If we have some salt dome like this, we can pick some point inside salt dome, and this point can extract some seismic attribute, like attribute number one, attribute number B, and this is guide for prediction the salt dome. So if we suppose the envelope attribute is very high and the amplitude here is also very high, we suppose that we can predict it any salt dome in the area because we have criteria to search in the salt dome. So this is a classification. So the difference between cluster and classification: cluster is unsupervised, classification is supervised. Regression is another technique. Regression is relationship between data with each other. So this is very also important to predict some petrophysical and also some reservoir characterization. So regression is key point and also is very, very important. So I will close voice of mobile. So now we can create some relationship between attribute number one and attribute number two, and this relationship can help me to create some equation. But the difference between the normal relation and the machine learning relation, we can use divided data to three parts: one part for training, other part for validated. So this is, and the other part for testing. So this is the key point. The normal regression, we can't do that. But for machine learning, we can divide data to many parts. So this is another part for analysis. So cluster is unsupervised, classification is different, supervised, and regression is technique for predicted petrophysics on others. So how it is work? What is the machine learning? Usually machine learning work is as data analysis. So if we think in the machine learning, we think in the machine learning is part for data analysis. So if you analyze data well, if you study your data well, you can create best model to predict your fishes or petrophysics or anything. So so thinking in the machine learning as the data analyst. As a good data analyst, that means you analyze data, make relation and correct model and repeat it and iteration many times until we get the lower error and know the best attribute we can use. The study of computer also algorithm that allow to computer to program to automatically improve. So automatically he improve her performance. So we try to training data by data analysis and testing data. So still the human is important to guide and the testing model and also change the hyperparameter of algorithm. So what are the big data? The big data is mean we have a huge amount of data that can't solve using normal PC. So we need a specific PC. Nowadays we have many cloud around the world use a huge amount, a huge specific hardware. This hardware can solve the problem you have. So this is technique also is very important. Usually big data mean we have variety, we have different type of data, maybe logs, maybe seismic, core and others data. And also we have a lot of variability, so that means we have different data types and the relation not related to each other, and we have a huge amount of variability. The change between value is very large. Sometimes we have a high amplitude, another time we have very, very low or negative amplitude in another time. So this is a technique we must take care about. And also visualization is very important because we need to visualization data and analysis data. Velocity is technique is important for some of data using in like geosteering, and we want direct analysis data. So fast analysis data sometimes is very, very important. So the big data, that mean we have different variety of data and the different classification of data. Some data need analysis in the same time, like geosteering. Analysis data have a large variability, and also another data has different variety between log and core and seismic. So thinking about the machine learning work and try to integrate this data with each other, this is the difficulty of machine learning, because we have different type of data and we wanted to integrate this data with each other. Usually, data analysis is a technique help you to combine and analyze data like the video. So you can analyze data and choose the best attribute, the best logs, the best bit physics can combine to get the sweet spot in the area. So this is a technique help you to test data and analyze data and make relation, statistical relation, and see what is the best relationship. But what is important of data analysis for machine learning? Usually the important of data analysis to reduce uncertainty. Because the machine learning, it is not like human. Usually we have a lot of uncertainty and maybe many answer for our problem. So we need something to reduce uncertainty for the model. The only technique can help you to reduce uncertainty is data analysis, because data analysis will control, give you all the option to control the parameter and the test model during model and after model and before model test hyperparameter. So this is a technique is very good for data analysis data. So second important this example, we want to predict some mass transportation normally like this. The mass transportation usually result from gravity, because we have abrupt change of gravity result from some tectonic. This tectonic effect in the shape of the earth and maybe creates some abrupt change faults, and this faults maybe creates some cleave on some cleaving surface like this. This surface may be pushing a lot of mass in different direction, as you can see. Usually this mass have a specific parameter for interpolator. Usually we have a lot of heterogeneity, usually we have a lot of discontinuity, usually we have a lot of parallel data to each other, maybe we have same bit little bit. So we have some parameter. This is called deterministic. So we can use geological concept. Some expert can help us to give us some criteria of this anomaly or feature. Maybe you have a variety of the sandstone or maybe shale and other subarticles. Maybe give me a lot of heterogeneity and a lot of discontinuity result from different between lithology and many parallel in the surface, as you can see. So this is called deterministic analysis. We have another technique is called stochastic analysis. Stochastic is what is the research nowadays, all you scientists or maybe mathematical and physical specialists try to develop this technique to reduce the effect and the contribution of human. So they try to push the software to use analysis and statistical analysis without interference of human. But until now, in petroleum simulation, we haven't complete 100% success of this technique. We still need human to control the relationship and choose the best data we can merge with each other. So for deterministic, this is one of like geophysicist, maybe geologist, and he tried to search in the, this area, and he study the mass transportation result from tectonic effect and variety of particles. So he discovered that we have coherence is low because discontinuity is increased, and also we have a lot of heterogeneity. We can use some attribute for textures in this technique, and also we can use non-parallel or parallel technique, as you can see here. So mass transportation can identify by this technique. Another option for deterministic, usually we need expert for this topic, but for geological data analysis or geostatistical analysis, we need some geophysicist have good experience of type attribute and they can mix this attribute with each other with our target. So this is different from geology a little bit. So now we have many techniques for statistical as a mass. We have univariation, we have bivariation, we have time series, we have spatial and multivariation. Univariation will study change of data in one direction. Bivariation will study change of data by two direction, two relationship between maybe amplitude number A and amplitude number B, and we have some relationship. Also we have another technique is called time series, is like autocorrelation. We need to compare different value, like we have sand gamma ray value, and this gamma ray change from high and low, and we search of repetition of high value. That means we have shale for repetition, so this is called autocorrelation. The special is mean we study the variation of data we have. The variation of data, that means if we have map and we have two wells and we have two value of porosity. Some value here is maybe 20 and other maybe 30. So for statistical, we ignore distance. But for geostatistical, the distance is important. So now we have something called the variogram. The variogram is the relation between variance between data and the distance between two points we have. So this is the variogram we have. So multivariation is a change and many relationship between different attributes each other. Sorry about the theoretical, because I wanted to introduce, because this is we spend many the course time in this, but this small session I wanted to focus in some basic. But in I have course for machine learning, maybe it is 5 days, 3 days, 3 hours per day, so it is different. We spend many time in statistical analysis, but now we have different technique, univariation, bivariation, time series, and special and multivariation technique. This is some example for result from Attribute Studio. I want to thank GeoModeling to let me test Attribute Studio, one of the best software in the world for machine learning. I tested OpenDetect before, and also it is different because this is give you all the control for data. So you can make cross correlation or maybe cross plot between data, and also you can test your predicted along the cross plot. So sometimes we need to make sure there is no conflict, no mixing between two clusters. The red cluster maybe may sometimes mixing with others, so we need to make sure which relationship is good. So I think this relation is good. I think this relation a little bit is difficult. Also, this relation is difficult, so I can ignore this attribute. I can accept this attribute and this attribute blue. So this is good to test data, by the way. Also, this is another cross plot. This is bivariation, give you some correlation. The correlation, it means we make relation between attribute number one and attribute number two, and make the correlation between both. If the correlation high, that means the point near to the fitting. So that means the relation is good. If the correlation bad, that means point far, and that means we can't create equation or correct equation in this technique. So this is important for us. So this is another way to look at data, by the way. So also bivariation and univariation can mix with each other to test clusters, as you can see here. So as you can see, the cluster is completely isolated in the curve here. So this is another important point we have. So this is also important. We do summarization this point. We have compared between the human effect and also the machine. The human is different. Let me to accept, sorry about it. I will accept some people. Give me 1 minute because this is sending me in what's. I don't know. Okay. Sorry again about this. Just a minute. Okay. Just a minute. Again, what is the difference between human and the machine? The human different completely because human have limited time of work. But the machine can work 24 hours, and also machine can be a high performance machine. Maybe for machine learning, we need a high performance machine, we need a high graphic card, we need high processor, high amount of RAM. So maybe GPU, multi graphic card, it is important for this technique. And also for machine learning, we have a chance to analyze data and to compare data with each other. So this is very, very important point. For also human, we have limitation, but we have imagination. We can imagine the change of data. We can easily identify the different of type of data we have. So we have two advantages. One advantage for machine learning, another advantage for human. So we can't ignore anyone. So we need to mix between human and machine learning. In this, we need both machine to a statistical analysis and analysis high amount of big data, high variety of data. It is impossible to analyze this data by human. Difficult. It's very difficult because we have a